Hi, my name's Kate Maddern and I'm a research agronomist here at BCG. So today, Friday 10th of September, we're standing here at our barley grass trial at Kenmare. So we're about 14 k's northeast of Rainbow. This trial here was sown on the 18th of May into relatively dry conditions and then received follow-up rainfall about 2 weeks later. So the crop is Razor CL wheat and we're lucky that it's looking quite good at the moment because we're on a vetch hay cut. So that little bit of extra moisture is meaning we're not seeing the signs of moisture stress that the rest of the district around here is. So this trial is funded by GRDC and is led by Dr. Gurjeet Gill at the University of Adelaide. And what we're trialling here is different herbicide methods to control barley grass. We're seeing that barley grass is becoming an increasing problem in dryland cropping systems, partly because it's evolving to germinate later and later, meaning that we get fewer knockdown opportunities on it. We're also seeing that it's increasing its ability to drop its seeds earlier and earlier in the season, which means that unlike ryegrass, most barley grass seeds don't make it into the bale when you cut it for hay. Instead, they've already dropped or they're that fragile that when the cutter bar comes over, they disintegrate and fall on the ground, meaning we're seeing higher numbers into next year's crop. And as like most of our weeds, we're also seeing that barley grass is evolving increasing resistance. There's well documented cases of group A, especially quizalofop or targa resistance, as well as group Bs. And then for the first year this year, BCG has found that there are cases of glyphosate and paraquat resistant barley grass across the Wimmera Mallee. While barley grass traditionally hasn't been seen as much of a problem and is generally easily controlled by chemicals, this changing weed means that it's becoming an increasing problem in our cropping systems. Whereas once barley grass might have been seen as semi-useful sheep feed before it ran up to head in September, what we're now seeing is that it's an increasing problem in our cropping systems, and this trial is looking at some possible herbicide options to try and get on top of high populations. So this trial has 10 different herbicides in it. It's got 6 pre-em treatments applied at sowing and then 6 post-em treatments applied when the barley grass was at GS13, so just 3 leaf stage in early July. So I'm kneeling here beside Intervix, which is probably a pretty standard grass weed control in a group B or an IMI resistant wheat. And as you can see, it's done quite a good job. Whereas here we've got Atlantis, which probably isn't a typical option in barley grass as it's only rated for suppression. And as you can see, we've got a pretty heavy barley grass density here, to the point at which we're expecting to see a pretty significant yield reduction. So something that can be quite difficult, especially early on in the season, is trying to tell which grass weed is which. Because each of our brome, rye and barley grass will have slightly different herbicide options, so it's always important to know which weeds you've got when formulating spray recommendations and mixing up spray brews. So here I've got a brome grass plant and a barley grass plant, and what you'll see is that when you're looking at your barley grass plant, it'll have these nice big auricles on it, similar to a barley crop. And as you can see, it does kind of just look like a very narrow, skinny barley plant. Whereas your brome, what you'll see is there's no auricles here. The leaf sheath is open and there's not those wraparound arms that we saw in the barley grass. So what'll happen from this trial from now on is we've got really good weed density data. We will then collect panicles to see how many seeds are set to work out how well we've controlled the weeds. And this trial will also go to harvest, so it will have really good yield data about the effect that the barley grass competition has had on yield. So stay tuned, we'll be discussing these results in our manual article that'll go in the BCG Season Research Results Compendium and talking about it at Trials Review Day. So if you're interested, stay tuned for some really good findings about how to best control barley grass in broadacre cropping systems. I'd also just like to thank our site host here, Lucas Puckle, for generously allowing us to run this trial.